Hey, what's up? I'm Jordan Fisher from the new Netflix movie, Work It, and I'm gonna set the scene for where I was in some of the big moments of my life. My first rehearsal for Work It, I literally just landed in Toronto. I had a red eye the night before. I walked into this little dance studio, this awesome dance studio, and we just started digging. And basically, I went straight into learning material for the film. It was a great way to set the table for what was gonna be a really awesome summer. Actually, it was many moons ago. It was the very first Radio Disney Music Awards. We met like in the line for the red carpet, and it was like, oh hey, let you know, I know you just signed to Hollywood Records and got a new show. I'm Jordan, nice to meet you. And that was that. And over the course of the next handful of years, and so we would do a bunch of different events and things together, but had yet to actually work on anything together until Work It. It's a song called All About Us. It was my first song that charted on radio. The very first time that I heard it on the radio, I just left a studio. I got in the car and there it was. It was the debut, my first single. Hearing it on the radio for the first time, I cried. It was such an incredible moment. I was working on a project in New York. I got a call asking if I would be willing to come and read for the director for To All the Boys 2 and Lana Condor. And thankfully, the chemistry between me and Lana was immediate. We adored each other and knew that we could do something really great together, which was awesome. And Lana and I just had, it was instant friendship, and I'm very grateful for that. Noah and I actually go way back. We met a little over a decade ago, just in LA, same circles of friendships and whatnot, and auditions here and there and that kind of thing, but had never actually worked together on anything. We were just homies. My very first night in Vancouver before I started filming, he had just gotten offset, hit me, and we went on a little date and had dinner and caught up, and it was a beautiful process. I love my whole To All the Boys family with my whole heart. My first video game system, it was a Super Nintendo. That was the beginning of my, I guess, lineage as a gamer. I had a Sega Genesis, Nintendo 64, PlayStation 1, like GameCube, you know, every new generation of console that came out was such a big deal to me. And I am mainly playing everything on PC now, have been for the last few years. That's my favorite, you know, that's my everyday now. I have a whole room in my house dedicated to it, and I love it. And I owe all of that to Super Nintendo. I'm in Nashville. I'm playing at a conference. My set was at 10:30. I ended at about 11. Got off the stage. I had a missed call from Tommy Cale, the director of Hamilton. He said Anthony Ramos, he had just booked a series that he had to start working on, and they needed somebody to replace him ASAP. He said, can you be here in the next 48 hours? It happened literally like that. It was all of a sudden I was just in New York and I was doing Hamilton. Magical. The idea of making my Broadway debut in what was and probably still is the biggest show on Broadway was an incredible thing. The night I filmed Grease Live was a roller coaster. A handful of us got sick a couple of days prior. We were filming on multiple sound stages all over Warner Brothers and had to hop on golf carts to go from point A to point B in real time. Like that was the craziness of that night. But it was fun. It's Grease, you know? How we felt on set was so special. And hopefully, if anything reads that night, that's the thing that reads. And it did, and it read very well. And that was probably the biggest turning point in my career. Please check out Work It, only on Netflix.